advised, on initial contact, you have information Delta.
Can you guys hear me?
Bonanza Tower information Delta, 1750 Zulu, 1330 at 6, visibility 10, ceiling 7,500 broken, temperature 23, dew point 11, altimeter 29er, 79er. Instrument and visual approaches in use, landing and departing runways 34 right and 34 left. Use caution for bird activity in and around the airport. Read back all, hold short instructions. Advise on initial contact, you have information Delta.
Custom ground, good afternoon. It's helicopter 9233 Foxtrot. Information Delta, squawk company code, ready for departure. We're heading north.
November 90233 Foxtrot, Manassas ground, departure frequency 127.32. And dead contact, one ready. You should remain clear of all movement areas.
PD Fox, over to tower, departure 2732. Welcome. All right, guys. You all, everybody hear me okay?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
All right. Excellent. Yeah, I can hear you. All right. So remember, you guys, the squelch is going to be turned OM, so speak loudly. All right, I'm going to pull off the dolly. We're just going to do a little hover work over the grass, give him something to shoot.
John, can you hear me?
And then we can talk to him on the radio.
John, do you have me? Copy?
Absolutely.
Cool.
All right. Now, do you need to talk to the guys on the ground at all? No? Okay.
Not right now.
I'll take care of that.
Standard Delta Whiskey, thank you. You can continue.
Standard Delta Whiskey, you're welcome.
All right, coming up.
Tower 227 Echo Mike.
227 Echo Mike Tower.
Sorry about that. We're 3-4 left at Alpha, ready to go northwest VFR.
Roger, the aircraft taxi out should be coming behind you to go to the run-up block B. Pull up number one.
Manassas Tower, helicopter 9 Delta Whiskey's high and tight for a right downwind for 3-4 right, practice 180 auto.
Crew is requesting 9 Delta Whiskey, 3-4 right, clear for the option.
9 Delta Whiskey, clear for the option, 3-4 right.
All right, guys, what do you think? You're flying.
Oh, it's great. It's
wow.
Great. I love it.
This is pretty amazing. I was not expecting to go backwards to start, but wow.
All right, left pedal turn.
So smooth.
It's a lot smoother than I thought it would be.
Well, it's a camera ship, so we spend a lot of time on track and balance to keep it smooth. Okay, put the tail into the wind. And circling back around. So that's the pedal turn. So that's all with your feet. That's just moving that tail rudder.
But that whole move was just with your feet.
Yeah, so if you look at my right hand, I'm just keeping it steady. So constant movements. If you look at the collective, it's hardly moving. But watch the feet now. So I'm just put a little bit of pressure. More pressure. Then as I come back into the wind, wind catches us. So I put a little forward psych again. And we're back to even keel.
So how hard is that to learn to use your feet in?
It takes a bit of work, and it's mostly, actually the feet part's not the tough part, it's the cyclic input. So as you see, if you watch it, as I come back around, we put the wind on the tail, I've got to pull the cyclic back to keep us from getting blown forward. Then as we make the turn back into the wind, the helicopter sees it starting to push, that's the wind. So I got to give it a little bit of forward cyclic to circle back around. All right, let's go flying.
Okay.
Be advised, I don't know if it's wind, my radio or wind on your mic, but you sounded a little bit staccato.
So something else an air camp airplane can't do is fly sideways. Good afternoon, it's helicopter 9233 Fox Air Florida. Holding short of Bravo Golf, ready for departure, we're heading north.
In November 33 Foxtrot, so what's your onboard heading?
Stand by one. Be about a 330, man. We're just going to be heading up the west side of Dulles.
November 33 Foxtrot, roger, present position, departure feature, going around 1340 at 11. Traffic in the helicopter turning right for a 14 runway 34.
Air float, okay, we're looking for the traffic negative site. We've got the one on the upwind on the west runway, but negative contact on the helicopter.
November 33 Fox, use caution, that helicopter is approaching
midfield. 3D Fox, we'll go. We kind of swim like a fish. That's normal.
Tower, November 936, pop up, runway short 34 left at Alpha, ready for takeoff.
November 936, pop up, Manassas Tower, runway 34 to left, proceed on course, clear for takeoff.
34 left, clear for takeoff, proceed on course, 36 Alpha, 36 Papa.
November 6, Golf Foxtrot, runway 34 right, number 1, clear to land.
Fox, make the switch, see you in a little bit. Tunnel Bridge, good afternoon, helicopter photo checking in.
Air photo, helicopter Potomac site, welcome, your transponder reserve, proceed on course outside the Bravo.
On course, clear Bravo, air photo, welcome, just be advised, photo mission, we're going to be heading to the RML 215 at 8 DME.
And what altitude?
1,000, sir.
Roger, thank you, and just main clear the Bravo.
Air photo, welcome. All right, so right now we're about 800 feet, putting along at about 70 knots, about 80 miles an hour. It does not feel that fast. That's, if you look at the airspeed indicator, which is the green-faced instrument there, the inner scale is miles per hour, the outer one is not. So right now we're about 80 miles an hour.
What's the top speed of this helicopter?
If you look at the red line there, it's 130 knots. So it's all contingent upon how much power we have. So with the doors off and four of us in here, we're pretty heavy and we're not very clean. So airspeed is, you know, a movement in the air. Ground speed is right there. So we got a pretty stout headwind.
Okay.
So showing 80 knots and 63 ground speed, so about 20 knots of headwind.
How did you get interested in flying helicopters?
My dad was a fixed-wing pilot. I grew up in Puerto Rico, and so I used to fly with him in the summers. He had a Cessna Skymaster, which he used for his business, and I used to ride along with him and take pictures. And there's this helicopter operation that's on the other side of the field that always looked pretty interesting. So, 98, was doing a little bit of IT consulting, had some money in the bank, a little bit of spare time, so came out here and said, what the heck, I'll take a lesson. And then that became two, and then that became three, and here we are.
We are currently in the air at about 800 feet, is that what you said?
800 feet.
About 800 feet, I'm being piloted around by Steve Bussman of Bussman Aviation. Steve, thank you so much for giving us a ride today.
My pleasure, you guys picked a good day for it.
It's amazing, you can really feel the wind up here.
Absolutely, every little gust and bump. All right, there's our power lines down below at our 1 o'clock.
Now, that's one of the things that you actually do with this helicopter is inspect power lines. What's that all about?
That's correct. Yeah, a lot of utility companies, the most efficient way of inspecting lines, insulators, static lines is to do it from the air. So coming up here outside the aircraft at about 1 o'clock, you have a Dominion Power transmission line. It's going to proceed to the north, so basically to do a power line inspection, the utility company employee would be sitting up front on the right-hand side. So we slowly drop the helicopter down, so we're just about slightly above the line. We'll turn our nose into the wind, and the inspector will basically look at the aircraft and examine the wires and the insulator. Sometimes we do it with gyro-stabilized binoculars. Other times we use a LiDAR device that can literally see electricity leaking.
Wow, that seems like it may be a never-ending job.
It's constant.
Why is a helicopter a good aircraft to do that?
Well, as you can tell, we can fly very slowly. And let's say on this tower I see for something that's catching my interest, I can slow down even more. Bring the aircraft to a stationary hover and let the operator take a good, long, hard look. Once we're comfortable, there's no fault in the line, we just push forward and continue flying. Otherwise, we also don't need an airport to land, so if I'm operating out in the field and need to refuel, I can basically set down anywhere there's a level spot, have a fuel trailer there, gas me up, and I'm back in the air.
Tell us about how far this can fly and the fuel that it uses.
Sure. This is a turbine-powered helicopter. We burn kerosene, so Jet A fuel. And we hold 64 gallons of fuel. And it's right below Beth and John in the back cabin there. So as we burn off fuel, it does not change our center of gravity, so we don't have to compensate for that. So on a good day with zero wind, we can get from here to New York. It's about 200 nautical miles on a full tank of gas. It's about 2 hours, about 100 knots. And after about 2 hours, you're ready to get out and stretch your legs.
You have to drive this with both your hands and your feet, is that correct?
Yep, at all times. Yep, there's no autopilot in this machine, so both hands, both feet are in working the entire time. So if I have to make a radio change, for example, where I need to use my right hand to do that, I have to put friction on the collective so I can take my left hand, move my left hand to the sidekick, now I'm flying with my left hand, use my right hand to make the adjustment, move my right hand back, come back to the collective, remove the friction. That's why the military in these machines will put the command seat in the left. Because that way you just take your left hand to make the radio change, your right hand always stays on the cycling.
How long did it take you to learn to fly a helicopter?
Well, the FAA basically says after 40 hours of flight instruction, 20 hours of ground school, you are fully equipped to be able to take your check ride. Most students, if they really work hard, so they're flying 2 to 3 days a week, with very little regression, are ready in about 60 hours. I have not yet met anyone who's ready in 40. So the flight instructor is the one that determines whether you're ready for your check ride or not. So if he says you are and you fail that check ride, it's a black mark in his record. So he's going to be very confident that you're ready for your test before he cuts you loose. So most students, after about 5 hours, are hovering the aircraft, and somewhere between 10 to 15 hours, they're ready for their first solo.
Is that first solo scary?
It is. You wouldn't think so, but it is. And normally the way it works is you'll be flying at the airport with your instructor. He'll ask you to land. He jumps out, says, see you later. And off you go.
You ever been scared in a helicopter before?
Never. Nope, we've had warning lights come on, but knock on wood, nothing's ever gone wrong. It's always been able to get me back safe and sound.
That was 155 Tango Victor, correct?
Now that there are many more drones, have those caused any issues for you guys?
No, it hasn't. For us in the D.C. market, drones are not allowed to fly inside the flight restricted zone, so for us, we're lucky that they don't pose much competition. Most of the photo work we do is at, 800 feet, 1,000 feet, up to 2,000 feet. Drones aren't really illegally allowed to fly much above 400. A lot of our photo work, we're covering multiple sites in one flight, so in a 2 hour period, I can cover 20 to 30 locations, and we're all done. If the drone operator was doing that, he'd have to pull over his van, get out, set up, go fly, pack it all up, move it again. He'd be out there for a week to do the same thing.
Jeff, one of the things that you can't see back there is Steve is constantly adjusting the
5 foot stick,
the stick with the wind.
Oh, okay. It is windy, but the ride is really smooth.